What about a tip for a young goalkeeper in this area who would like to play someday in the National Hockey League?
Play center or left wing.
Play center or left wing.
It's a good thing that Terry Sawchuk didn't take his own advice, because the National Hockey League would have missed out on perhaps the finest goaltender the game has seen.
I would rather have him on my team than trying to score on him, let's put it that way.
Gets his shot away and Sawchuk made the save.
Number one, the reason he was so good is God-given talent, you know. One thing you can't teach in sports is talent.
Brilliant save by
Sawchuk. Terry'd win games for us, and we looked up to him because he was a great goaltender. I like to say you couldn't put a pea by him.
Terry Sawchuk became the full-time netminder for the Detroit Red Wings at the age of 21, taking over for future Hall of Famer Harry Lumley, who was traded to the Chicago Blackhawks. The youngster immediately demonstrated he was prepared for the challenge, winning the Calder Trophy as the league's top rookie in the 1950-51 season. Playing sensationally behind a dominant Detroit team that featured legends such as Gordie Howe, Ted Lindsay, and Red Kelly, Sawchuk earned the Vezina Trophy in three of the next four seasons, and the Red Wings won the Stanley Cup in 1952, 54, and 55.
He was 6 foot and about 210 pounds, so he was filling more of the net than most goalies of his time.
He had the ability to position himself in that net where you had very limited area to score. He knew where he was all the time.
He was extremely agile. He had a new technique because screenshots were becoming more prevalent, and he had a crouch. He would be looking through the legs rather than standing more upright.
He always got into that crouch and just got up on his feet fast. When he was right, there wasn't anybody much better than he was.
Following the 1955 Stanley Cup victory, the Red Wings traded Sawchuk to the Boston Bruins. The goaltender missed time during his second season in Boston due to mononucleosis. Then, following his recovery, Sawchuk abruptly announced his retirement after suffering from nervous exhaustion. However, he returned to the game and his former home when the Bruins sent him back to Detroit in July of 1957. Over the next seven seasons, he would once again star with the Red Wings, during which time the team lost three times in the Stanley Cup Final. Sawchuk's next stop was sharing the nets with Johnny Bower after he was acquired on waivers by Toronto. His stellar play continued with the Maple Leafs as the veteran duo shared the Vezina Trophy in 1965. In March of 1967, Sawchuk became the first goalie to post 100 career regular season shutouts.
Don't know what to say. I'm just thrilled to death. I was thinking more of the game up to about the last 5 minutes, and I thought, well, I got something going for me now. And then a couple of them just missed the post. They could have ruined it all, but I'm thankful that they didn't.
Later that season, Sawchuk played a vital role as the Maple Leafs won the Stanley Cup. He would spend the next year with the expansion Los Angeles Kings, 1968-69 in Detroit, and his final campaign in New York. Following the Rangers season, Sawchuk tragically died at the age of 40. At the time of his passing, his 447 wins and 103 shutouts were NHL records. While those marks may have been surpassed in the decades that followed, Terry Sawchuk's place among the NHL's all-time greats remains.